Who wins a fight between Bobby Lashley and Ken Shamrock? Well, we're about to do a fantasy fight breakdown, so stay tuned. Hello, fight fans. Welcome back to Fantasy Fight Breakdowns. My name is Damien. Here, not only do we make dream matchups using superstar fighters of today, all the way through to legendary fighters of the past, we take an in-depth look at the fight. I break it down as technically best as I can to predict a winner and by what method. I myself am a student of MMA and Jiu-Jitsu, but most of all, I'm just a massive fight fan like you guys. So let's get to today's matchup. For episode number 12, we have Ken Shamrock, nicknamed the most dangerous man in the world, coming up against the heavyweight phenom Bobby Lashley. This is another fan fight viewer request. I'm doing these videos each and every week, so if you have a fantasy matchup that you want to see me do a breakdown of in a future episode, let me know down in the comments below. Ken Shamrock, of course, started out in his professional wrestling circuit in Japan before transitioning to mixed martial arts in the 1990s, while Bobby Lashley started out first in the pro wrestling circuit in America before transitioning to MMA in the late 2000s. These two were actually scheduled to fight back in 2009, but after beating Ross Clifton, Ken Shamrock tested positive to steroids and the fight never eventuated. But I'm going to be doing a breakdown of this fight right now. But first, let's get to the rundown of the show. Of course, in order to do any sort of accurate breakdown of the fight, we need to have some consistent rules at play. So each fighter has been assessed in their prime years. Every fight will be assessed if it's taken place in an MMA-style cage, and match rules are taken from UFC 1. This means there's no weight classes, no timed round, no judges' scorecards. We'll take a look at the keys to victory for both fighters before I give my own breakdown analysis of how the fight plays out to predict a winner and by what method. Let's get to the matchup. So for this matchup, we have Ken Shamrock from 1996. Coming up against Bobby Lashley, 2016. We can see Bobby Lashley with the reach advantage, 78 inches. He has 11.5 reach advantage over Ken Shamrock, while he also has a 2-inch height advantage, plus a good 35 pounds over Ken Shamrock in this fight. Both of them being MMA fighters with a strong pedigree of wrestling. Ken Shamrock is a shoot fighter, training out of his own gym called the Lion's Den, while Bobby Lashley is a strong wrestler with good, tight boxing. He fights out of the American Top Team Academy. Ken has won the UFC Superfight Championship while also winning the Pride Grand Prix in the year 2000, while Bobby Lashley won the XFN Heavyweight Championship just before signing with Bellator back in 2013. Bobby Lashley, for a big man, has a nice boxing technique with a nice sharp 1-2 combination, and he looks for the big uppercut as his big punch. Ken has more looping hooks. Of the two, Lashley definitely has the boxing advantage in this match for sure, especially with that 11.5 reach advantage. Both men prefer this fight to be on the mat after using their instinctual wrestling abilities. We can see Ken Shamrock with an overall skill score of 91 points has a slight edge in the skill score department over Bobby Lashley, who has a total skill score of 87 points. If you want to see how I got those skill scores for both of these fighters, I've linked both of their fighter breakdown videos in the description. Let's get to the keys to victory. Taking a look quickly at the keys to victory for both men, starting first with Ken Shamrock. He needs to scramble well. Bobby Lashley, although I think he's got the slight advantage on the feet, he's still going to want to take Shamrock down, get him to the mat, and try and grind on him from the top. So therefore, Ken Shamrock needs to scramble well and quick. He needs to dig those underhooks in, prevent the takedown, or at the very best, scramble to a better position if Lashley is successful with that takedown. He's got very creative submissions. He's going to have the slight grappling advantage in this fight, but what he needs to be careful of is the bigger, stronger, heavyweight punching power that's going to be coming from Bobby Lashley. While Bobby Lashley, although Ken Shamrock's going to have the advantage when it comes to leg kicks and kicking ability, he's still going to want to keep the fight standing because I believe he has better boxing than Ken Shamrock. If he does get a takedown, he wants to use his weight advantage to keep Shamrock pinned to that mat, not give him any space in order for him to start getting some submission techniques. But what he needs to be careful of is Ken Shamrock's scramble. He doesn't want to get his back taken while trying to get a takedown. And he also needs to be careful when they get to the mat that he doesn't find himself in an awkward position and caught in one of those legendary leg locks that Ken Shamrock has. So let's break down the fight. I mentioned earlier that both of these fighters have similar strategies. Use their pedigree wrestling ability to score a takedown. Once on the mat, Ken Shamrock uses his grappling ability, while Lashley originally used ground and pound before evolving more into mixed martial arts and becoming better at jiu-jitsu. After this, he became better skilled at using submissions to get the wins in the fights later on in his career. The fight, of course, starts standing. Lashley, aware of Ken Shamrock's own wrestling ability, will be cautious from the start, which will allow Ken to attempt and land some lower leg kicks. This is where Lashley will want to use his 11.5 reach advantage and work his boxing skills. Lashley will want to threaten with some punches before a quick level change, shooting for the double leg takedown. But I can see Ken Shamrock will be able to defend this initial attempt, getting the underhooks and going on the offense with some knees. The fight remains standing, but both fighters want the fight to be on the mat for their own advantages. Shamrock has the ability to use his catch wrestling. He'll initiate a clinch and try to use some dirty boxing with more knees, trying to soften up Lashley to make the takedown easier. After a bit of hand fighting to gain control, Lashley, still fresh, will be strong enough to break away after taking a little bit of damage from Shamrock, not allowing him to get the sweep. Lashley will want to get back to his basic combinations of boxing before landing a decent straight right, catching Ken Shamrock on the chin. Lashley gets to the clinch and takes Shamrock's back easily enough and slams him down to the mat. Shamrock is experienced enough to pull guard and defend himself from any heavy, damaging blows. Lashley is now going to be tired from the previous exchanges, while Shamrock is the more experienced and better cardio fighter. He's going to be able to handle Lashley's ground and pound. I mentioned in the fighter breakdown video of the accounts from other fighters and training partners who told of how physically strong Ken Shamrock was. Both of these guys are obviously both gifted naturally and unnaturally athletes. Just to look at them, you would automatically say that Lashley has the strength advantage. But I would argue that in the strength department, it is very even. And even when it comes to wrestling and grip strength, with his experience, Ken Shamrock may even have the advantage here. Although Lashley is strong and has a submission game, I don't see where he successfully secures a submission on a prime Ken Shamrock. The other factor now at play is how tired Lashley is becoming, and he has, in his previous fights, proven to be human by becoming increasingly sloppy when he gets exhausted after initially going very hard early on in his fights. Shamrock, with all the experience and grappling ability, especially with leg locks, is now where he wants to be on the mat. I can see him scrambling from the bottom to a heel hook and securing it without enough defense from a tired and slightly unsuspecting Lashley, who is not too familiar with the advanced techniques needed to defend a submission like this. After the scramble, taking control of his legs, securing the heel hook, this fight is all done. There's nothing that Lashley can do from here. Although Lashley, with a decent record of 15-2, it's just not comparable the careers that both of these guys have had in MMA. Lashley has just not fought the other world-class competition that Ken Shamrock has. And I think that because some of the lower caliber opponents that Lashley has fought, some of his wins came from his opponents basically wanting an easy way out and giving up in the fight. Giving up is just one thing that Ken Shamrock would never do in any fight. Although this is a close fight and I think that Lashley has the potential to win on any given night, in my opinion, Ken Shamrock in his prime is just too good for Bobby Lashley and is going to get the win via a heel hook or other leg lock. So there we have it, fight fans. The winner of episode number 12 is Ken Shamrock, getting a submission win over Bobby Lashley. As always, let me know down in the comments below if you agree, if you disagree. How do you see this fight going? Let me know if you have a fantasy matchup that you want me to do a breakdown of in a future episode. If you haven't already and you like what this channel is about, hit that subscribe button, hit that like button. Thanks to all of you for watching, and I'll see you guys next time here at Fantasy Fight Breakdowns.